the short back straightaway here in the El Toro Speedway. They dive in once again to that big turn three and four, led by Eric Jones. Daryl Moore, two of those next in line, and then last year's runner-up, Kyle Larson.
Running in fourth is Tony Knowles, Ben Kennedy is fifth, J.R. Hefner is sixth, and Joe Cobb is seventh. The leaders now coming up on the Joe Cobb truck on the back stretch.
And the truck length, and it's Kyle Larson.
Second qualifying race, a lap from going green. Tonight's broadcast, a pole qualifying for the 1-800-CAR-CASH Mudd Summer Classic, is brought to you under exclusive radio rights granted by NASCAR to Motor Racing Network solely for the private, non-commercial use of our listening audience. Any publication, reproduction, or the use of the description and accounts of this event without the express written consent of the Motor Racing Network is prohibited. So the first heat was caution free. The second one about to begin, and Kurt, remember last year, only one quick caution in all five of the qualifying races.
Let's see if that holds up here this evening. The green flag is unfurled. The second of our heat race is underway. Rookie driver Mason Baker starting on the pole from the outside lane over to turn two.
And there's trouble behind him. John West Townley will spin into turn number one and will collect one other truck. About to pull out on the track. Do want to let you know, the winner's share of the 50-50 raffle at Eldora now pushing $15,000. The winner's share of the 50-50 pushing $15,000. If you've not yet done so, you can get 50-50 tickets behind the main grandstands at the top of turn four and at the top of turn number one. Remember, half of the money, half the entire pot will go to a lucky ticket holder at approximately 9 p.m. this evening. The other half benefits the West Ohio Food Bank and the Tony Stewart Foundation. But again, the winner's share of the 50-50 pushing $15,000. Heat race number three for the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series now out on the speedway.
Truck of Jennifer Joe Cobb. Steve Post, one interesting note. We should remind everybody that the fuel that you burn now in qualifying and these heat races will not be able to be replenished before we go racing for the feature later today. It's going to mess with these teams' strategy.
Yes, indeed it is, Eli. 150 laps here at Eldora Speedway is doable on fuel, but throw in 10 laps of heat races, a couple laps of qualifying, and it is at best on the edge, but will likely have to see fuel stops as the race unfolds.
Remember, there are five qualifying races total, and then the last chance qualifier before weekend. Two
push into the exit of turn number two. Drifts down off the banking just a bit onto the back straight.
Finishing in second.
gets the 88 of Matt Crafton and the winner of qualifying heat race number 4 in the Brad Keselowski Racing Cooper Standard number 29 Ford third generation driver, ladies and gentlemen, Ryan.
Race their way in. You've got the 59-year-old veteran Ken Schrader out of Midland, Missouri, and the 23-year-old out of Midland, Texas, Tyler Young, again winding up first and third respectively as the field now comes off turn number 4 and heads down for the start.
Out of the corner, they look for the green. There it is. Jim Lopez, and there goes Schrader. He's getting gone like he always does here. He is one of the strongest runners, stays on the high side. It's double wide, maybe three wide behind him.
Three wide for the second spot.
Leader Ken Schrader off of turn number 2. Schrader wobbles a bit, hangs on to the race lead. Now trying to fend off Ryan Silas from that spot.
Now remember, Kenny Schrader and Tyler Young are really racing each other for that final transfer spot. The other drivers are locked in. Schrader is taking no chances. He's gone to the front and he's taken off with the race lead.
Yeah, the best thing Ken Schrader can do right now.
Johnny Sauter right to the bottom of the racetrack. And that seems to be where the players have been here. This last one, Schrader pulling in right in the middle lane. Sauter all the way to the bottom again in turn 3.
Sauter trying to stay there in that green, silver, and black truck. But Schrader in the white, blue, and orange colors taking off. He's run here, Schrader has, since the early 1980s. He knows this place.
A lot of laps here for him. That truck has spun through turn 4, trying to get it refired.
Here's Forrester now still sitting in front of where the leader are entering turn 3, and as a result, the yellow flag comes out.
So wherever you are across the country or around the world, the epicenter of racing tonight is here in Eldora, and we're so happy you're with us.
Green flag is about to be unfurled. It's in the air now as they come up turn 4. Remember, those caution laps did not count in these qualifying races, so 5 laps to go. Ken Schrader, the leader, but he's challenged by Johnny Sauter.
Starting on the inside of the racetrack. That's where Sauter has been almost most comfortable in his qualifying heat race. Schrader restarting up top side and may cost him the race lead.
And remember, the man running in third, Tyler Young, is the other truck trying to race his way in. So Sauter is the new leader, but Young is going to challenge Schrader if he can get there off turn 2.
Young is closing in as Schrader slid up high.
Sauter takes the top spot, and there you have the